athletes of Maryland against the skilled players of Gonzaga. Contrasting styles of play. When Maryland walked in the gym and the eight teams that practiced here, if I could pick any team out that I would want to mold into a defensive powerhouse, it would have been the Maryland players.
But Gonzaga, the higher-ranked team, as we give you a look at Star Watch for the day, and Maryland will be putting the basketball in the hands of Nick Kaner-Medley quite a bit. Adam Morrison can do it all for Gonzaga.
We know about Kaner-Medley's ability to score. He's going to be tested as a rebounder all season. You've got to begin in this game. Adam Morrison, they've got to get him down as a defender. He's got a great middle game. Has he established his three game over the summer? We're going to see here in just a moment.
The starting lineup now for Maryland. They're going to put the ball in the hands quite a bit of DJ Strawberry, the 6'5 point guard. Kaner-Medley can certainly shoot it out of the gym. The guy that impressed us the most in the workouts, though, was James Giss, the 6'8 sophomore. Gonzaga, as high as number 7 in the polls in the preseason, is Gary Williams. His team right now, the Maryland Terrapins, ranked 20th. And Giss, Gonzaga with 20 wins or more 11 times in the last 12 years.
Giss looked to me like a Wallace athlete from the Pistons. I wouldn't be surprised to see him lock down Morrison. Let's see who he starts on. Oh, he's going right to Batista.
Altidore's just putting taking it. Now it's knocked away almost at midcourt as Sean Mallon races it down for Gonzaga. There in the blue. Ravio can't get it to go. Derek Ravio from Vancouver, Washington, who had 19 in their victory over Idaho on Friday night. So Gonzaga has already gotten into the win column. A pushing foul right along the baseline there as Kaner-Medley is fouled. We give you a look at Mark Few, who has just done a spectacular job for Gonzaga. They climbed as high as number 2 in the national polls last year, en route to 26 wins.
Great evaluator of talent and has done a wonderful job recruiting.
Medley on the catch, can't get it to go, and Adam Morrison gets his first rebound of the day for the number 9 Bulldogs of Gonzaga. And they quickly strike the first two of the contest, getting inside the J.P. Batista. He started out hot against Idaho. He had 23 points and 9 rebounds, so keep an eye on him today.
He's gravity challenged, but I'll tell you what, he's got the width and girth. He can be a great pin steel guy down in that low block, and he has the softest hands of any big man maybe on the floor.
Strawberry kicks it out. Batista front irons it, but follows his own rebound, and from the line gets it to go.
McCray has wonderful separation to his shot. He's got that NBA lean back jump shot, and you saw it in evidence right there.
The shot won't go, but a foul as Gist went sprawling on the floor. James Gist, the 6'8 sophomore out of Silver Spring, Maryland.
This game is going to be played so fast. These referees don't need whistles. They need radar guns. I love this kind of a game. It's like the old Raging Cajuns of Southwest Louisiana facing Tark's teams of the Running Rebels. You know, I never played this style of ball because I didn't have these kinds of athletes. But I'll tell you what, as an aficionado of the game, I can appreciate the pace at which this game will be conducted.
Fabio on the line, the 6'3 junior. Good three-point man who averaged about 13 points a game as a sophomore and hit about 46% of those shots, overall 43%. So he's actually a little better beyond the three-point line.
Ravio looks like he came out of the school choir, but I'll tell you what, he can dig a dagger into you with his three as well as his passing prowess.
So Gonzaga now up by 2 in what we expect to be a high-scoring contest. Maryland averaging 77 a game last year. That was tops in the Atlantic Coast Conference. Beckway giving the ball off, and now Strawberry will set up the play. DJ Strawberry, the son of the big-time Major League slugger Darryl Strawberry, running the point for Gary Williams' team. He'll pull up and shoot, and it's short.
While they're in the zone, he had Kaner-Medley, a better shooter, up on the right side there.
Morrison up and inside and fouled on the play as well. He'll go to the line. Adam Morrison establishing himself inside.
He's an opportunistic scorer. He does that type of thing. He runs the floor in transition. Here we see him just keep coming. Watch him in there. Hard to get a body in a guy in transition. You saw that after Burner burst his speed in the last 3 or 4 strides there. He has great hands and wonderful timing.
At 15 points, 8 rebounds in Zaga's season opener against Idaho. One of the most versatile players in America, and he's given Gonzaga a 7-2 lead.
Gonzaga in that zone.
They try to get it inside to Gist, but it's picked off with quick hands of the Zags on the attack. And now Morrison, as you can see, can do a little bit of everything as he brings the ball up for the Bulldogs. Morrison on the wing. As McCray tries to stay with him step for step. Batista on the low block. Gist bumping bodies with him, but it goes anyway.
He's got that patented go-to left shoulder hook. I would never allow him to rhythm up to his left shoulder. I'd make him come back to that right shoulder every time. He's good down there going left.
A very confident-looking Gonzaga team here in the opening minutes in Maui. Dana Medley has yet to get a shot off. McCray with it way outside the three-point line. Gist zipping up top to Strawberry. He spins lightning quick, and it rolls in.
They need to get an inside touch. That was good that he took it to the rim there and created that gap. Whoa!
Ravio blocked against the backboard.
Two guys put that baby down.
And now Strawberry will force the tempo for Maryland.
So far, Gonzaga's done the better job in defensive transition of getting back.
Strawberry will set up a play now for the Terrapins. Shot clock at 17. Tanner Medley. Gist handling, or actually underneath. Got it free to Tanner Medley, and there's a foul.
Stepped out of bounds, I think.
I believe he did. That's the call. No foul.
And here's Strawberry. Drives, spins, hangs in the air, body control. He's a manufactured point guard. He's got a little bit of Chauncey Billups in him. He's going to have to learn to go to that middle game and take advantage of his great strength. Take a look at his shoulders and body versus Ravio, the point guard from Gonzaga.
Mallon brings it across midcourt. Trying to get a two out here. Now stolen away. Maryland, the dunk by Chris McCray. And look at the emotion by McCray, the senior.
See, you want to be out in that passing lane when you're Maryland and you're athletic. Plus, you want to always make sure number three, Morrison, catches outside of three, because if Morrison has a soft underbelly to his game, it's a three ball. You're right about McCray's emotions here. These guys got a lot to prove. This is a statement game for Maryland coming off what some would have thought was an abysmal season. How about when your program reaches that level where 19 wins is considered a bad season?
Yeah, backtracking in 19 and 13, an off year for Maryland. Here comes the pressure now for the Terps. Mallon to bring it up. And Ravio will take it with Strawberry guarding him. Pretty good matchup between those two. And he turns it over. Traveling violation as that foot moved a little on the defensive pressure by Strawberry.
Strawberry does a great job in not bringing his feet together, and he angles you off. He not only contains you, he steers you where he wants you to go because of his low body as well as upper body strength and size.
Fade away by McCray. Not there this time, but they pulled it within two. Morrison handles the ball on the baseline.
That's what I talked about in Star Watch with Kaner Medley not rebounding that ball and getting it back up. How about these hands and backflow?
And once again, McCray with a dunk. Chris McCray has tied it. He has seven, and boy, did he get those fast.
Yes, he did, and Gary told us yesterday, he says, I don't know who the star on the team is, but right now, it's McCray saying, hey, coach, how about me?
Great harassing pressure. Morrison pulls up, leans in, got it. Great touch there by Adam Morrison for
that,
two.
That guy has an unbelievable middle game. I mean, he adjusted that ball in the air, and he's not athletic.
Now, as a sophomore, he averaged 19 points, 5 rebounds, and he can pass a 2, 3 assists. Ebekwe up top, handling it for the Terrapins. Down 2 as the pace is heated up seriously here in Maui. It's Fitzfree. Now Bowers trying to handle it, turns around, and also turns it over.
You know, he's creating himself a bad shot. He should take it right at Baptista.
Will Bowers, the 7-footer, but the man going up and over everybody is this man, Chris McCray, the senior, with a couple of thunderous dunks for the Terrapins as they battle their way back.
Tiger, Anika, the Merrill Lynch Skins game this weekend on ABC.
Good time tonight.
Me too.
smell great longer, stay out later with new Red Zone After Hours Body Spray.
Everyone talks about how tough their truck is, how much it can haul. But when we build a truck, we like to think beyond the first load, to the second, the third, the fourth. That's why load after load, job after job, year after year, nothing stops a Tundra. Toyota Trucks, moving forward.
I had a really good time tonight.
Me too.
Smell great longer, stay out later with new Red Zone After Hours Body Spray.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by EA Sports NCAA March Madness 2006. In stores now. Toyota. Choose any direction as long as it's forward. Toyota. Moving forward. And Subway. Experience the new fresh toasted chicken parmesan sub today. Subway. Eat fresh.
A splendid afternoon here in Maui. Great to have you along. Rick Majerus, Dave O'Brien, the EA Sports Maui Invitational. You see Michigan State moves on over Chaminade earlier. Gonzaga, Maryland battling right now. Later tonight, Arizona, Kansas, Arkansas, and number three, UConn. Morrison off the inbound. Dipsy Doos and lays it in.
That's what I was talking about. That's unbelievable. He's got that net. They compare him to Larry Bird. You know what he is? He's Brian Winters as a little bit more athletic.
Got a lot of star quality, Morrison does, with a trademark hairstyle. Has him looking like the fifth Beatle. Igbekwe is traveling with it.
I'm letting you handle the hairstyle department. I'm follically challenged. Watch this body control right here. Take a look at this as Morrison gets this ball right here. He lays out nice to take the block shot. Outstanding. He keeps his head on the rim through the entirety of the mechanics of the motion.
Revere finds his man Morrison again, and they don't have anyone right now containing him at all.
Well, they're throwing over the press. What's happening here is he's in a little containment press. This press is hurting Gary. And meanwhile, this zone has kept, has done a good job of keeping the Zags in control defensively of Maryland.
And Medley threw it right into the Gonzaga defense. Pargo getting into the ballgame. Jeremy Pargo, Gonzaga's heralded freshman. Morrison on a follow. And he is already into double figures. Nobody found him. He has 11 points. Time on Maryland. And you know this is all going to be about how to shut down Adam Morrison, if that's possible for Maryland.
Spin, spin, spin the globe. It's your turn, spin the globe.
All around the world, Siemens provides hospitals and doctors with the tools they need to make the right decisions right away. From diagnostics to patient information to care management, we're doing our part to help people everywhere feel better.
Spin, spin, spin the globe. It's your turn, spin the globe.
Adam Morrison, 5 for 5 from the field, coach, 11 points, 2 rebounds, and we're only about 6 minutes in.
Boy, he runs the floor, Morrison. He gets offensive boards. He's just a pure scorer in almost every way imaginable. Very few guys have got that great middle game.
Strawberry trying to get it to Bowers off his hands and out of bounds. It'll go over to Gonzaga. So everything breaking right now for the Bulldogs.
They've got him frustrated. Look at Strawberry right here. His teammates don't need to be reprimanded for that.
Well, Maryland, however, with 4 turnovers on their last 4 possessions. That's why Strawberry is so frustrated. Thrown away by Gonzaga this time as Pargo is looking for a cutter. Mark Few, by the way, very good friends, as we mentioned, with Gary Williams. The two highly successful coaches hit it off at the John Wooden Awards 3 years ago. Both had players representing their school. Dan Dickow and the Terrapins had Juan Dixon. Gary Williams has traveled regularly to Spokane from College Park to help lead the Coaches versus Cancer fundraiser. Another traveling violation. That's 5 turnovers the last 5 times down the court for Maryland.
They're attacking the teeth of that zone and trying to play too much on the first side. I'd get that ball moved and get that zone shifted some if I was Maryland. I wouldn't sit there and attack the teeth of that Gonzaga matchup.
Maryland with 8 turnovers in the first 7 minutes. Barrio looking inside, dribbling to the baseline and stepping on it and turning it back over.
3 consecutive turnovers. I'll tell you one thing, these shot clocks can be turned off. If you need electricity surge, they can turn the shot clocks off. They're not going to be needed today.
Referees keeping up, Ed Hightower, John Higgins, and Bob Staffen. Jones to Bowers, good ball movement to Garrison, but he can't hit the shot. He was wide open, could not get it to go. Travis Garrison, the best rebounder, and maybe the man who will turn into the leader for the Terrapins. They're looking for that guy. Morrison, certainly the man for Gonzaga, and a rare miss today for him.
Yes, indeed, and speaking of Garrison, who wants your 6'8" man who's a powerful rebounder out there shooting the ball when he hasn't even warmed up coming off the bench?
Fargo to Morrison.
What a block.
Strawberry got it.
What a block by Strawberry.
DJ Strawberry high up, and now he's fouled. Rivio stepped out and hit him. 17-9, Gonzaga.
Look at this. This is your point guard. Your point guard. Not only does he block it, he brings it back in, cups it, and gets that, gets the rebound with it.
Strawberry with an injured knee in the Terrapins' 14th game last season, but he has rehabbed and come back fully healthy after surgery. Now Strawberry will take a step to the bench. And Gary Williams will bring on Sterling Ledbetter to run the offense at the point. He's a senior.
Ledbetter is a complimentary player, makes everyone around him better.
Jones, a very dangerous shooter, gives it up. In fact, Mike Jones, the three-point land, about as good as they get. He had 22 in a victory over Fairley Dickinson in the Terrapin season opener. He's got it now, gives it up to Kaner Medley, who's been very quiet offensively, and he threw it away.
The turnover, the zone has really bothered them. They're trying to beat it with dribble penetration and getting into a gap or a seam.
Pargo can't get it to go. Jeremy Pargo, just a freshman, but he'll get it back. He's their top recruit. Lost the handle, but it's out of bounds off Maryland. 11:53 left. The pace, fast and furious. Everything we expect from two top 20 teams in Maui.
Everyone talks about how tough their truck is, how much it can haul. But when we build a truck, we like to think beyond the first load, to the second, the third, the fourth. That's why load after load, job after job, year after year, nothing stops a Tundra. Toyota Trucks, moving forward.
Maryland at this pace is going to turn it over about 45 times today. 10 turnovers already. Gonzaga with a 17-9 lead here in our second game of the day at the Maui Invitational. Well, during the course of the season, the ESPN family of networks showcases a great basketball moment. The countdown will take us from A to Z, and it's time now for ESPNU's pride of the program. And in the spotlight, it's Arkansas.
Beck to the baseline, puts it out to Stewart, right side Furman. He's open for three, good! Arkansas leads it by three with 48 seconds to go. Grant Hill loses the ball. Dwight Stewart, out to McDaniel. Arkansas wins the national championship! The Arkansas Razorbacks have completed the dream season!
The Nolan Richardson leading his team to 40 minutes of hell in a national championship, and you'll see Arkansas later today. First at 9 on ESPN. The Maui Invitational continues. It's Arizona against Kansas at 11:30 Eastern. Number 3 UConn against the Arkansas Razorbacks. All part of our EA Sports Maui Invitational Feast Week presented by Lowe's. Morrison with it.
He'd like to have Baptista if he could.
Carvillo in and out on his three-point attempt, but there was a foul underneath the basket in a rebounding fray, and that will go against Gonzaga. And a personal foul against Pendergraft. David Pendergraft, a sophomore.
Maryland's 10 turnovers here have been self-inflicted. They met the enemy and it is us, as Pogo used to say. Gonzaga has not created the turnovers as much as Maryland has. Now, there's where you want to go with the ball against the zone. Right inside to that soft underbelly of the zone just below the free throw line.
Pendergraft committing the foul on Travis Garrison, the senior from Suitland, Maryland.
Here we see it right here. They flash in there. They got a guy behind the zone. They see one of that soft underbelly. He rushes his shot, Garrison. Garrison's too enamored with his jump shot. A big body guy like that should take a page out of Baptista's book and try to anchor himself a little bit more down on the block. Sometimes for those four men, they get baited into that perimeter jump shot as opposed to understanding where they can make a real nice living, that's down on the post.
Sean Mallon getting back in for Mark Few. Garrison at the line here. Big body indeed, 6'8", 240.
Terrific mobility, a nice bounce. 1-2-2 press now.
17-11, lead down to 6. Morrison has to bring it up, but he can do that. Ravio is the point guard. Derek Ravio, he is from Vancouver. The 6'3 point man. Fargo going up against Jones. The shot clock at 17. And a traveling violation. Gonzaga gives it up. And they have turned it over 6 times in this one.
I'll tell you what, if Morrison does have an advantage, he should have a big offensive advantage on the mismatch of Kaner Medley. Kaner Medley can't take him off the dribble or to the middle game. Gonzaga extending the defense, falls back into their matchup zone.
Jones trying to find Kaner Medley. It's deflected off of Gonzaga, and so the Terps will keep it.
They want to make it happen too fast, too early. You know, if they ever got to the third side of the floor with that zone, they can still go with their fast break and up the tempo of the game with their press.
Gonzaga has shot the ball a little bit better. They are 7 out of 15 from the field in the early minutes.
I like this look with Kaner Medley on top of the key.
Jones off the fake. And he's fouled on the play. Stopping it at 10:48 left.
I believe it's on Morrison, and if it is, it's in fact his second one.
Now it'll go against Fargo instead. And that's his first.
Yeah, there's a sigh of relief from Few on that one there. That foul didn't go to Morrison.
You're darn right here. With less
there you go, right there. That's the open hole.
A foul against Gonzaga. That'll go against Hayfeld. That picks up his first. And it's time to shoot. Ebekwe will go to the line. McKenna Ebekwe.
You see him flashing from behind the zone into the open hole. Right there. Drops, takes it. Now, he wasn't there with his feet set. He moved in on him. That was a good call by the official. Hightower's an excellent ref. He's one of the few refs I know the name. I know the name of the 4 or 5 guys that are dogs, and I never divulge those. And then I know the names of about the 8, 9, 10 really good ones. Thornley, Hightower.
But you do keep a dog list.
I have a dog list. There's only 4 or 5. Referees don't affect games. I didn't have to keep the list. I got those guys indelibly etched in my memory.
I would like to see the list, though. I think all of America would love to see the dog list of referees.
Here's my answer to the dog list. Hang loose. Give them a chuck a sign here. We're in Maui, baby.
I got you. Relax, have fun. And one of these two teams will be moving on to round 2 in Michigan State. And whoever comes out of this one, that will be a terrific matchup as well. The catch by Batista. Got it back out to Ravio. Man, with a man right in his face. Strawberry basically guarding him into his own bench. He still knocked it down.
That kid is underrated, and I think it's because he has that choir boy appearance. The last Gonzaga guard with that was named John Stockton.
Jones, long distance, got it. It rattled in.
NBA range.
Indeed, Mike Jones, the former Parade and McDonald's All-American out of the Boston area, starting to come into his own, although he commits a foul here on the double team. Gonzaga up 20-14 over Maryland. Number 9 against number 20. It's ESPN2 Feast Week presented by Lowe's from the Lahaina Civic Center in Maui. Dave O'Brien and Rick Majerus alongside. And the winner has Michigan State, which pulled away from Chaminade and won rather easily in the second half. That is what is at stake for the winner of this one.
You might wonder why we have such a low score with such a high toward pace. It's the fact that Maryland has 10 turnovers and only 13 shots on goal. Gonzaga has 5 turns, but at the quarter mark here, we have 16 turnovers in the game.
Oddly, too, because Gonzaga's actually shot the ball pretty well. Batista inside, and he is fouled on the court. Fouled before the shot. J.P. Batista had a standout season opener against Idaho with 23 points and 9 rebounds.
He has such a wide body, wide shoulders, big butt, phenomenal hands. He can catch anything. He's got soft hands for a touch, and he has strong hands. So when you go with the composite hands, he fits all three criteria.
Trevio again, not this time, trying to make it 2-for-2 from way out there. McCray with the rebound. Here come the Terrapins. Strawberry back in and running the point. Garrison facing up off to McCray now. 9:33 left in the opening half.
Gonzaga is an offensive juggernaut. They have excellent offensive execution and just run their plays wonderfully well, as evidenced by the separation he had to that wide open shot.
Jones, he can certainly hit it out there, and it falls in again. A lot of rim, but it goes from three.
Nice draw, kept gap dribble, and you'll notice, Dave, that was to the second or third side of the floor.
Fargo weaves his way in for two. Boy, he's got a quick step.
Quick step, the Chicago freshman, brother of a guard who plays for the Bulls.
Jones lost the handle on it. Pendergraph finding Reveal in front of everybody for an easy layup. Gonzaga with a quick strike off the turnover. Reveal, by the way, now has 7.
And the half-court speed kills. Maryland's got to establish a dichotomy or distinction between when they've got that fast break and when they're in the half-court.
Gaynor Medley can't get into the scoring column.
They're living 3 now against the zone, and they're falling into the trap that Gonzaga wants them to go into, where they just settle for jump shots.
Pargo got airborne. Fed it off to Batista, and he's hammered on the play. And you mentioned Jeremy Pargo, his brother Gennaro, played with the Lakers, Toronto, and with the Bulls after a career at Arkansas. So excellent bloodlines. Jeremy Pargo, a highly touted recruit from Chicago. Morrison coming back into the game. Adam Morrison, the All-America candidate, returns. And Sean Mallon takes a seat for Mark Few.
See, 3 outstanding scorers on the floor. Morrison, Batista, you got, and then you've got Raviot. When your point guard can get to the rim with the ball, draw and kick, as well as extend the 3 because of NBA range.
Zip pass inside, but off the mark that time. And Hayfield can't get it to go. 8:25 left here in the first 20 minutes. 24-17 Gonzaga. Gonzaga actually started with their highest preseason ranking ever at number 7. And with a streak of 7 consecutive NCAA tournament appearances, including the Sweet 16 a couple of times, the Elite 8 99, they have become a national power, recognized in the polls. It's Jones again with a miss.
And that's their 4th consecutive 3 against the zone.
Batista, nice catch in traffic, and he's fouled. He'll be shooting 2. 8:03 to go in the half.
He's a deceptive runner. He's a willing runner. He'll give you all he's got on the run. He's not a speed demon by any means. And as I said before, he's a bit gravity challenged. But I'll tell you what, he's a very astute player. He comes from Brazil by way of junior college out in Nebraska of all places.
Physically imposing, you'd have to say, though. It's 6'9", about 270 out of Olinda, Brazil.
You know what happens? He used to play with that trapezoid lane, that wide lane. Therefore, he's had to make his moves from a greater distance out. Even though we've widened the lane with these experimental rules here, this kid is accustomed to the widest lane in basketball, and therefore that's been a real advantageous to him.
Do you like this, by the way? But it would seem you'd get a lot better interior passing.
I like the lane at this width, maybe a little bit wider. I would like to stretch it out, that three-point line, not to the international three, but to the exact medium between the NBA 3 and the collegiate 3. I think that would open up the game more for cutting, passing, posting.
College game currently at 19-9, and with this experimental three-point land that we're using in these preseason tournaments, so to speak, it's 20 feet 9 inches. That's why you see the double line.
Maryland's treating the zone. It's a 2-3 zone. It's a matchup, and they're treating it with the two guards on top. I would get a point and two wings and then get someone in the middle of it and someone behind it. But it's always best to coach from this position.
Shot clock down to 4. Strawberry gets it off in time, but caught too much iron. Garrison had position, and he's fouled.
Good patience. That's what you want Garrison to do. Go in there and rebound.
That's about the longest Maryland has held onto the basketball in any one possession so far in the first half, which has Gonzaga out in front.
Everyone talks about how tough their truck is, how much it can haul. But when we build a truck, we like to think beyond the first load, to the second, the third, the fourth. That's why load after load, job after job, year after year, nothing stops a Tundra. Toyota Trucks, moving forward.
Now the big game really is in your room.
That's unbelievable!
ESPN and Fisher-Price introduced the ESPN Shot Block Basketball.
Got them on nylon!
It's the only basketball game with built-in defense, featuring the voice of ESPN's own Dick Vitale.
Wow, what a nice shot!
With electronic scoring and real crowd noise,
shoot!
The ESPN Shot Block Basketball gives you 8 different ways to play, from rookie to pro.
What a performance like that! You might be on SportsCenter!
Take it to the hole with the ESPN Shot Block Basketball. In stores now, batteries not included.
When you first bring him home, RoboPet is bound to raise a few eyebrows. Interactive and loaded with personality, train RoboPet with a remote control or just let him do as he pleases.
Can he play dead? Please, don't get up.
RoboPet reacts to sound, sight, and movement and can look after himself even when you're not by detecting table edges and obstacles. So move over, Rover.
Whatever.
RoboPet, a fusion of technology and personality. Batteries not included from Huawei.
In a world where one play can turn a contender into a champion, comes a story of unparalleled pressure, and only those with nerves of steel will survive.
At the buzzer! Oh!
NBA League Pass presents a thriller where every second counts. Follow the ball. Be a part of the thrill.
Oh my goodness!
Don't miss a minute of clutch NBA action. Get NBA League Pass from DirecTV for just $189. To order, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit DirecTV.com.
And then you talk about it.
Gonzaga up 26-17 here in the first half, 7:28 to play. All part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's, the EA Sports Maui Invitational. And there's a lot of pressure inherent with Gonzaga's success. Just ask Mark Few, their very gifted head coach, about all the great things they've done. Their fans still want more.
People get kind of a little bit spoiled with success and they want more success, you know, so there's a lot of pressure on the program, a lot of pressure on the players, but I don't think it's any more pressure than what we put on ourselves as competitors. But expectations have definitely changed over the years, but that's a good thing. I really think that's a good thing.
They were number 2. That was as high as they got last year in the national polls, winning 26 in another West Coast Conference championship. And the Zags would lose a squeaker to Bob Knight's Texas Tech team in the second round, 71-69. But that Gonzaga squad was the 4th best shooting team in the country. And building off of that with the junior All-America candidate Adam Morrison, and more great things expected. But Rick, that's the way it goes. You know, you win 21 year, they want you to win 22 the next.
It's always more fun on the way up, I'll tell you that. It's the journey.
Garrison with the miss, and the rebound comes out high to Pargo. Gonzaga leading 26-17 in this matchup of two top 20 schools. Morrison off the fake goes right on Kaner Medley, but a miss and a foul right on the baseline. It'll go against the Maryland against Gonzaga.
Kaner Medley played that beautifully. He stayed down. Morrison tried to bait a foul by jumping into him. That was a great no call by the official.
Hayfelt pitching up. That foul. 26-17.
Hayfelt, the redshirt freshman, was recruited all over America. This kid's very athletic. Look at the length of his arms.
Sean Mallon returns for the Zags here as Gist goes to the line. He led the Terps in shooting a year ago. the 6'8 sophomore out of Silver Spring, Maryland, and he has a vertical leap that he showed off for us during a workout yesterday, around 40 inches.
He's a freak athlete. He's got the whole athletic package, body control, hang time, lateral quickness, explosiveness. He jumps really well a second and third time. I love this kid. This kid could be the defensive stopper of all time in the ACC if he put his mind to it. 1-2-2 press now. They're going to get more pressure on the inbounder.
Fargo beats it on the dribble, though, and hurries it into the offensive zone, but also turns it over. Now, in game one between Chaminade and Michigan State, I think we saw two palming violations.
Yeah, that was a good call by the ref. But here's the deal with Fargo. They're smelling blood. Freshman guard coming into a game. Ravio's out. That was a good call by Maryland to make it a 1-2-2 with a hard trap early.
Dana Medley takes the baseline. Gives it off to McCray for two.
Nice draw and kick right there. The thing that made that so special was Medley is not, you're not expecting a guy with that big boxy body to be a draw and kick guy in that situation.
Fargo just got out of the pressure. Nathan Downey. Now they swing it to Fargo, and the freshman can't hit it. But you're right, they're centering on him when he gets the ball to midcourt, and he's having some difficulty with that.
And they got Ravio coming right back in now. They see where the problem is. Oh, what a play!
Strawberry flying down the lane with a tip.
The thing that made that special, one-handed control tip out of your area. And I say control tip.
Maryland is rocking and rolling here. They pulled it within three. Fargo bumping with Strawberry, and Strawberry fouls him with the body.
Strawberry is trying to intimidate him physically. He knows he's a freshman. Take a look at this tip right here. Oh, man, coming from the right side of the rim to the left, right at the apex of the ball. Great control, nice touch on the tip. That wasn't one of those stab tips where you're fortuitous if it goes down. That was a control tip. Let me underscore that word controlled again.
Strawberry, the eldest son of the former Major League slugger. His dad belted 335 big league homers and was a talented hoopster in his own right in another lifetime at Crenshaw High in Los Angeles. He's actually recruited to play basketball at Oklahoma State, signing a letter of intent.
Was his dad a great, great baseball player?
One of the great sluggers of his generation. And, of course, outside life caught up with Darryl in a tragic way. Fargo at the line with the miss. And Kaner Medley there for the rebound. And the shift in momentum has clearly gone to the Terrapins here as they've pulled it within four at 6 minutes to go in the first half.
They got to get Ravio back in because he settles him down and he's such a good decision maker.
Maryland on a 6-1 run. They're trying to get Kaner Medley involved, but he's starting way outside. Garrison flips it up, and it caught the iron, and a rebound is cradled by Morrison.
They get a good look at it, though. That's the spot where you want to go. They've had success with that spot.
Adam Morrison, the hottest player on the court in the opening 6 or 7 minutes. Mallon on the high post. Morrison trying to feed inside. Got it to Mallon. Got a pretty good look, but missed it. Retrieves. That won't go. Gist had the rebound knocked out of his hands. And now, as you predicted, Rivio is going to return to the game here for Gonzaga. Mark Few going to his bench as Gonzaga has possession.
This will be something for Morrison, I can guarantee that. And Kaner Medley has made more of a believer out of me. That would not have been my choice to match up with Morrison, but Kaner Medley has actually done a nice job on him.
Will Bowers, the 7-footer for Gary Williams, comes back into the game. Morrison handling the ball out high. Kaner Medley guarding him. Batista has an open lane to the basket. He stops and travels with it.
Bowers jumped for the fake. Batista made a nice ball fake. He went for it. It was almost like one of those quarterback keepers. I think he was so surprised he was that open. He got nervous. He wasn't going to dunk anyway. He's not a dunker.
The Zags with 8 turnovers here in the first half. Maryland down 4. McCray will shoot from way downtown, and he nails it.
Long ball, NBA 3.
He's got 12. A scramble, but Gonzaga will keep it. A 1-point game.
Right now, if you're Gonzaga, I'm going to get the ball to Morrison no matter what I've got to do to get it there. Or let Radio take it. But I want to get Morrison back into the scoring groove of things. He's been quieted down here.
Maryland on a 9-1 run. Pressuring the inbounds. Raviot deep in the backcourt.
Raviot never forces. I like that about him. He's assertive without taking any bad shots.
Altidore Cespedes taking it. It's a young man from Montreal, Quebec. Another turnover, and how about the pressure? Relentless defensively to force a ninth turnover and a spate of turnovers in the last 3 minutes.
Well, listen to what I said at the start of the game, because that's what's coming on here. The most skilled players are the Gonzaga players. The best athletes are the Maryland players. This presents an interesting dichotomy for the fan to watch. Skilled, that doesn't mean that, you know, a guy like McCray can't hit a three. But what happens is McCray can get separation off that NBA one-foot fadeaway, square his hips acrobatically when he gets in there off a little curl, you know, and Gonzaga doesn't quite have that kind of an athlete. Baptista's not an athlete. You know, Gist is a world-class athlete. If Gist was grew up in France, he'd be a decathlon guy.
Well, these two schools split two previous meetings. Gonzaga winning back in 2004. 1995, they met in the NCAA tournament. Maryland won that easily, and now it's the Terps who turn it over for the 12th time.
That was a slippery ball there. That wasn't Kanan Medley's fault.
Batista holds it high. It's slapped away by McCray and out of bounds.
If you're a fan and you want to learn how to move without the ball, Morrissey's a clinic on that. The way he changes pace, changes direction, he really governs his speeds well. He's very elusive relative to his change of speed. He's not particularly fast, but he understands how to go two or three speeds.
Batista off the inbounds. Morrison calling for it. Adam Morrison with a childhood diabetes since the age of 12. And that has been well documented. He'll pull up, and he's fouled by Kanan Medley. But Morrison has become a role model for children with diabetes to live a normal life. And he has been a star for Gonzaga here in the first half. 3 minutes and 57 seconds left. And Gonzaga clinging to a one-point lead in the Maui quarterfinals.
Welcome to Universal Exports, purveyors of fine 00 products. Top international spies place their confidence in the QLab customized special edition 1963 Aston Martin DB5. A car that you will take for a sleek two-seater is actually a weapon. It's fun to drive, and it blows things up at the touch of a button.
Bond, James Bond.
From Russia with Love. Rated T for Teen.
What do you do when he's hungry for meat lovers, she wants a supreme, and you want your favorite? Well, Pizza Hut's got the answer. The new More For All Pizza. An extra large pizza topped any four ways you want for just $13.99. More for me, more for you, more for all.
I want to go over a few things before you leave for Oslo. 80 gig, titanium, Wi-Fi,
secure.
Should you find yourself sans laptop, check in with this. Bluetooth, broadband, built-in camera.
Secure.
If it's on our network, it's secure.
Encrypted, hacker-proof, titanium.
It's a pen.
Security, powered by Cisco.
What do you do when he's hungry for meat lovers, she wants a supreme, and you want your favorite? Well, Pizza Hut's got the answer. The new More For All Pizza. An extra large pizza topped any four ways you want for just $13.99. More for me, more for you, more for all.
Dave Revson in the studio coming up on our halftime report. We'll get you ready for tonight's games. Arizona and Kansas, UConn and Arkansas. Also hear the comments of Fran Fraschilla and Hubert Davis. And guys, what are you thinking?
Well, Maryland has clawed back into this game with aggressive defense, sense of urgency at later moments.
Yeah, Gonzaga needs to take care of the basketball. They have to limit their turnovers.
Great intensity so far in the first half. Let's send it back to Maui, guys.
Dave Geis, thank you very much. Adam Morrison started the game 5 for 5. He's now 5 out of 8 with 5 rebounds. They continue to look for him, but he has cooled somewhat. And that, along with that defensive pressure that Fran was talking about, has made this a tight one, as we expected. 1 point, that's the lead for Gonzaga.
What we're seeing right here is the new rule change. You used to have to shoot these foul shots before the timeout. Now you shoot them after. Garrison bricked his 2, and Morrison comes back with that classic stroke. He does have the most beautiful mid-range stroke. I can't figure out why he's not a more proficient three-point shooter. My deal is, I don't think he gets his legs into it enough, because this guy has one of those great schoolboy Indiana strokes.
Good foul shooter, as you'd expect, 76% from the line as a team. Gonzaga was one of the best free throw shooting teams in America last year, 74%, which was top 25. So keep that in mind. If this one is as close as we expect, it will be down the stretch.
Hugh does a good job on something I neglected to do as a coach. He allocates a lot of time for shooting every day, and he works a lot of time on foul shooting. I did the foul shooting, but I didn't allocate the time he did for shooting the pace.
You never stop learning, do you? Gist inside, missed the bank shot. And Mallon with the rebound, and Gonzaga on the attack, leading by 3. In a lower scoring game than we anticipated, with high octane offenses, but vastly entertaining. Watch Gist as he goes up. Oh man, does he go high.
Watches that baby down. And the reason is low scoring is there's so many turnovers and steals. This game has been rife with turnovers and steals.
Maryland in their opener on Friday against Fairleigh Dickinson scored 111 points as they won 111-85. Morrison doubled up, lost the handle. Batista knocks it out of bounds. It goes over to the Terrapins.
That ball didn't slip out of his hands. Maryland did a good job of coming to attack penetration. I like Morrison, though. I like how clever he is. He's very crafty.
Well, his team started hot, nailing 7 of their first 10, but Gonzaga 3 for 15 since. The rebound is tipped in by the 7-footer, Bowers, and Maryland has the lead.
Maryland has substituted liberally. Gary's played 10 guys, and you can see the benefit of it.
Fargo on the drive, gets inside the paint, did not shoot it. Knocked away by Strawberry. Man, is he quick.
Wow.
How about that slam? Time
out. Beware the turtle. They're going wild over the turtle section.
And they're going wild for DJ Strawberry on the pick and the dunk. 32-29. DJ Strawberry providing some offense from up close, but it comes off of his defense.
Strawberry does such a great job intimidating you defensively with his length, with his strength. Look at him here. Look at him guide him right there. Look at that ball pressure on the used dribble. How about this block? How many point guards can make a block on a 6'8 wing forward in transition? Now look at this right here. He's so energized. Now he's into the now right there. He's physically imposing defensively. He gets out and plays the pass lane. Once in a while, he'll gamble and make an ill-advised gamble and get caught on it. But I'll tell you what, energy, excitement, enthusiasm, that mayor's Strawberry in the back of that jersey.
And he has been right in the jersey of Rivio throughout the first half. Maryland, by the way, in a 16-3 run in about the last 6 minutes.
He's been so aggressive with his body that the refs aren't actually calling fouls, where he's been kind of chucking Rabiot bringing that ball up.
Batista with Bowers, the 7-footer, blocking the shot and committing a foul on him.
Batista's got no lift. All Bowers had to do was stay down. Bowers should never go to jump. He's got no lift either. It's two guys who can't jump, and one of them's trying to leave his feet and block a shot.
Just a little over 2 minutes left in ESPN2's coverage of college basketball continues with the Guardians Classic tonight. A semifinal doubleheader, number 13, West Virginia against number 2, Texas. And then at 9, it'll be Kentucky taking on the Iowa Hawkeyes with a trip to Tuesday night's championship game on the line. Rick Majerus, Dave O'Brien, and Mike Swanson with us courtside, the courageous Swanee, handling all our outstanding stats today and throughout the tournament. He's only got 12 games to work.
12 games,
and you and I get a vacation for 6 because Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, and Bill Raftery are coming on for the nightcap games later today.
I want Swanee's prostate.
12 games.
I've never heard that said of another human being. Foul right there on the baseline with a minute 49 left in the half. Maryland up by two. And Mark Few in an absolute dogfight. He knew he would be with his good buddy Gary Williams. The Terrapins, of course, won the NCAA title 4 years ago. One season after Duke beat them in the Final Four. Of course, beating the Duke Blue Devils. Billis always loves to hear this. That's what Gary Williams does better than anybody. Gist at the line, drops in one.
I applaud Few and the Gonzaga staff. They run something nice for cancer. Called the basketball thing. That's where he and Gary developed that friendship and relationship. Well, actually, when they both had players that were highly thought of as Wooden Award candidate winners, but they do a great job with that up there. Helps so many kids, the Jimmy V Cancer Foundation.
Nice stroke of the line for Gist. His good touch. He's also a pretty good piano player, from what we understand. 34-31. Maryland up by three. Rivio with a pull-up. Ledbetter got a piece of it. Sterling Ledbetter backs it out. He'll run the point here for a moment for Gary Williams.
Gonzaga in man-to-man now. We're out of that zone.
Jones well defended. Now three on one as Parville will dribble and get fouled on the play.
That's a good foul right there. He might have been able to catch a charge. The referee made a nice decision. It was the correct call. But nevertheless, he didn't give up a layup right there. He's going to make him earn at the free throw line, especially Pargo being a freshman.
Pargo, terrific young freshman. Well, I guess every freshman's young. Turned down a scholarship offer from Illinois to leave his home state and head west out of Robeson High School in Chicago. He's at the line here shooting two. He has four first half points. Chris McCray getting back into the game for Maryland here for the last minute 18. And Pargo with another foul shot on the way. He's 6 feet two, and the freshman hit the pair.
He's showing nice composure here for a freshman, especially with the turnovers. He didn't play the game backwards. He didn't allow himself to get rattled.
Gonzaga has cut the lead to one.
Both teams runs this flex offense. Both teams, this is a staple. It's a five-man spread floor, baseline cutoff, back pick offense.
McCray tried to zip it underneath the Ledbetter cutting, but it's out of bounds off Maryland. They turned it over 14 times. Although the major reason that the Terrapins are leading here by a point is that they've cut back their turnover rate big time the last 7 or 8 minutes.
And we talked about those early turnovers being turnovers of omission, not turnovers of commission. Commission turnovers are good.
Pargo looked for the back door, stolen away by McCray. And now 42 seconds left in the first half. Pace has been furious, not as high scoring as we thought it might be, but vastly entertaining. And now Maryland will run off some of that clock here in this possession.
Spread floor, let's see what kind of play they're going to go to. Who would you bring that ball to here? I'm going to get McCray a shot if I'm. Oh, Gonzaga does something very nice right now. Goes to a zone. Good call.
Ledbetter got inside. Bowers can't connect.
Why is Bowers trying to dunk? He's such a big body guy.
The shot clock violation.
Just take it up off the glass. I know you look like a farmer and there's no style to it, but I mean, that dunk is not your game.
Now they're going to talk about it. Ruled seconds ago a shot clock violation. Did not get it off in time.
And okay, who's on Morrison? McCray goes to Morrison. That's critical. Strawberry goes to Rabio. I like the matchups right here. Gist has got to give help. Gist has got to get up here and give help right now.
3 seconds.
Gist does.
Morrison launches a long one. And that's how the first half comes to an end with Maryland up by one.
And credit Gist with a nice job of giving help to maybe one of the most prolific scorers in the country, a preseason All-American. Gist did a great job there bailing his teammate out.
That's our Star Watch. Morrison did his part. Kaner Medley without a point, but Maryland made a terrific recovery. And at halftime, they lead it 34-33 over Gonzaga. Let's go to the studio.
Thank you very much, Dave. Dave Revson here alongside Fran Fraschilla and the newest member of our ESPN team, Hubert Davis. Welcome aboard. Guys, entertaining first half, certainly. A lot of good up and down play, a lot of physical play as well. What are the thoughts coming out of this first half?
Well, we talked about both teams being able to play at different tempos, and you saw it was a little bit slower tempo. But Adam Morrison got off to a great start for Gonzaga at the beginning of this game. This guy is versatile. He's a Player of the Year candidate. Can score inside. Very crafty. Also can rebound the basketball. Watch the shot. Good location on the offensive rebound and the putback. And then starts the break off the defensive boards. He's an outstanding passer as well. Versatility, also can shoot the ball. 13 points, 5 rebounds. Big reason they got off to that start.
Yeah, and I think Maryland did a nice job offensively, latter part of the first half, attacking the zone. They were selling for a lot of jump shots earlier in the first half, and that was a result of missing shots. And one of the things you want to do against a zone is get into the middle. You don't want to pass the ball around the perimeter. You want to penetrate the zone. And every time that Maryland did that, they either got a layup or a wide-open jump shot, and they made their shot. So they really did a good job latter part of the second half getting back into the game, and the defensive pressure was absolutely terrific. They turned the ball over and they got some easy baskets. DJ Strawberry was absolutely tremendous at point guard. He created so many turnovers.
Yeah, he was just outstanding defensively. That's one of the things that certainly stands out in the first half. Again, a great game, 34-33. Certainly anybody's game as we head to the second half. Some news items to tell you about. Donovan McNabb is going to have surgery for that sports hernia, so the Eagles quarterback is now done for the year. Reigning NFC champs, just 4-6 now in the season. They lost to the Giants yesterday without McNabb again. He is done. And Penn State, number 3 in the new BCS standings presented by Allstate. Their regular season is done, so if number 1 USC or number 2 Texas slips up, Joe Pa's crew might just end up in position to play for a national title. Adds a little intrigue these final 2 weeks in college football. Michigan State trying to bounce back from a season-opening shocker. Got a scare earlier from one of College Hoop's giant killers. We'll show you the earlier game from Maui coming up next.
Exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's for all your home improvement needs. Lowe's, where improving home improvement never ends. And Philips Flat TV with Ambilight. You'll never go back to ordinary TV.
Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays.
Come to Lowe's, where there's a store within a store with amazing holiday values. You'll find festive new decorations you won't find anywhere else, as well as a huge selection of quality pre-lit trees. Even new inflatable outdoor decorations that only Lowe's has. So come to Lowe's, where you'll save more this holiday season. Sweet home.
Turn off the Ambilight function on your Philips flat TV, and it's like going back in time. The only flat TV with Ambilight from Philips. You'll never go back to ordinary TV.
Nothing outperforms Gillette M3 Power Nitro. Push the button and feel the boost in performance. Gillette's battery-powered motor sends micropulses to the patented Power Glide blades. Get unsurpassed comfort and the world's best shave. M3 Power blows away the competition. You'll be blown away or Gillette will give you your money back, guaranteed. Try Gillette M3 Power, the world's best shave, or your money back.
The best in satellite television is being joined by the best in satellite music. Stop all the dancing, give me time to breathe. DirecTV is proud to offer over 65 channels of XM satellite radio. More urban channels. More hits, jazz, and dance channels. More of what you love than ever before.
Get all the college hoops you can handle with the ESPN Full Court Pay-Per-View Package.
Unbelievable!
More than 450 games you want to see.
Yes!
Top conferences. Critical matchups you won't get without ESPN Full Court. To order, visit DirectTVSports.com or call 1-800-GET-SPORTS.
Back on our halftime report, Dave Revson, Fran Fraschilla, Hubert Davis. It is a one-point lead for Maryland at the half, and kind of a back-and-forth game in Maui score-wise. Chris McCray leading the way for the Terrapins with a dozen. Now, the earlier game, Michigan State and Chaminade, as we kicked off Feast Week. Traditional giant killers, the Silver Swords, looking pretty good early on. Off the miss here, it's Chris Reeves, who was very impressive. He had 18, Chaminade up by one. Michigan State taking over late in the first half, though, Fran.
Well, Marquise Gray, 9 points, 8 rebounds. He needs to be a compliment inside to Paul Davis.
Now, late in the first half, Shannon Brown, in fact, the last play of the half, and this set the tone a bit for the second half. Michigan State scored the final 5 points of the first half, 18 there for Brown, and then pulled away in the second, as you'd expect, off the Maurice Ager miss. Goran Sutton with the rebound there. State out-rebounded Chaminade 41-32. Ben Ager hitting the three. He finished with 23 as Michigan State does avoid its first 0-2 start since 1976. Remember, they lost by 22 to Hawaii the other night. They beat Chaminade by 22 in this one as the Silver Swords fall to 4-58 all-time in this tournament. Putting this game aside, guys, and looking big picture here at Michigan State, a team that was in the Final Four last year, what do you see from the Spartans here early on?
Well, you know what, Dave? Ager and Brown are the best wings since Kentucky Fried Chicken. Those guys got 41 points today. But the key, I think, for Michigan State, point guard and also Paul Davis and consistency. Today, he had 16 points, 13 rebounds. Remember, Davis ended last season with four straight double-doubles. He's got to become more efficient inside, but he certainly plays with a nice energy level. And remember, already 27th all-time at Michigan State and climbing up the ladder.
Well, I think Paul Davis is going to need a little bit of help. He looked good in those highlights, but they really need their role players to step up this year. They have three stars in Maurice Ager, Shannon Brown, and Paul Davis. But what got them to the Final Four last year, I think, or helped, was their role players. They had great senior leadership, and they had consistency off the bench. They didn't have that against Hawaii. They lost that game. Today, they really had some good bench play, and I think that led them to win the basketball game. They're going to need good bench play in order to win a Big Ten title and get back to the Final Four.
That's why they got to feel good about Gray, who you talked about in the highlight there. 9 points, 8 rebounds, one of those complimentary
Delco players. Delco Rowley and Sutton, the freshman. They got a lot of bodies up front, but they need a second inside score to go with Paul Davis. Take a little bit of heat off the big guy.
So perhaps saw a little bit of that in this win today against Chaminade. Again, they await the winner of the game you're watching right now, Gonzaga and Maryland. And Adam Morrison certainly doing his part in the first half for the Zags. Nice little move there for the All-American. He's got 13. Gonzaga down by one at the break.
Now, when business takes you on the road, your network will be waiting. Broadband access only from Verizon Wireless. Wi-Fi only works in limited locations. But Broadband Access is the nation's largest high-speed wireless broadband network, expanding coast to coast. Now get unlimited access at a great price.
Go get them.
Thanks.
Verizon Wireless. It's the network.
We try to do a lot of things before we succeed. That's why we keep trying. Maybe all the times you tried to quit smoking before were just practice. Maybe you just needed the right help. Like the Commit Stop Smoking Lozenge. Commit is proven to help even those smokers who've tried to quit before. Commit works fast to help control cravings, and it keeps working even after the lozenge is gone. The 4-milligram Commit Lozenge actually doubles your chances of quitting. The Commit Lozenge. Real help. Real hope.
Classics. 24/7. Anytime.
For all my looks. On the way to the match.
Con mis amigos.
Classics with my cords.
When it's cold, eh?
With my vest.
When it's warm.
K-Swiss Classics. Year round.
K-Swiss.
You know why so many people like the taste of Subway sandwiches? It's simple. They only put on what you like the taste of. Every Subway sandwich is made fresh right in front of you, so you choose all the ingredients. The meat, the veggies, the sauces, the fresh baked bread, everything. No wonder so many people are leaving the burger joints and coming over to the great taste of Subway subs. Because when you really think about it, they don't make the sandwiches, you do. Subway, eat fresh.
Back in our halftime report, this is just the tip of the iceberg of Feast Week and some great games in Maui tonight, guys. We've got Arizona and Kansas, Arkansas and Connecticut. Who are some of the players we should look for?
Oh, there's going to be so many athletes in the Arizona-Kansas game, but Hassan Adams, a senior, finally all-time returning scoring leader right now in the Pac-10. He's a high flyer, Westchester High School in Los Angeles, and he will be Lute Olson's go-to guy, but Lute Olson goes 11 deep. Connecticut's got Rudy Gay. Some people think he may be the number one pick in the country. His intensity level continues to rise. 15 points against Pepperdine in the opener, but very inconsistent still. Jim Calhoun will get out of Rudy Gay, Dave and Hubert, what he did with Charlie Villanueva at the end of last year.
Well, I'm looking forward to watching Ronnie Brewer of Arkansas. He's absolutely terrific. If Rajon Rondo will calm down, Ronnie Brewer could probably be SEC Player of the Year. He's athletic. He can play three different positions. He can shoot the ball. He can defend. And he is the leader of Arkansas's team to get them back in the national title race. And what a wonderful matchup with him against Rudy Gay. These are two of the better small forwards in the country.
And it's an important game for Arkansas to get off to a good start this season. It's a big year for them.
Now remember, they turned down the NIT bid last year, and they are a team that's expected to challenge Bama and LSU in the SEC West. Probably the least talked about team in this tourney, aside from Chaminade, but it'll be interesting to see them tonight. Well, we've had a great game so far, and DJ Strawberry's been a huge part of it defensively for the Terrapins. Maryland on top by one. Back out to Maui next.
Oh, there's no place like home for the honeymoon.
Come to Lowe's, where there's a store within a store with amazing holiday values. You'll find festive new decorations you won't find anywhere else, as well as a huge selection of quality pre-lit trees, even new inflatable outdoor decorations that only Lowe's has.
For the
so come to Lowe's, where you'll save more this holiday season.
Sweet home.
The Tourist Cabin is designed to wrap around you. This is walnut inlay. The trim is chrome.
It's great.
It's got 12-way adjustable seats.
Get down! Could you just get down in your seat?
Yeah,
what? Just a little lower.
Diane, how are you?
Dave, looks like you're doing well.
Yeah, see you around.
Okay.
The elegant, capable Touareg.
Ex-girlfriend?
Yeah.
Come drive it. You'll get it. Right now, get a great deal on a Volkswagen Touareg.
At Samuel Adams, hops are to beer what grapes are to wine. They really are the soul of the beer.
That's why our founder, Jim Cook, goes to Bavaria each year to hand select the best hops in the world. Most other brewers just call in their orders.
Oh, this is gorgeous.
Some customers only drop them and sniff a little bit.
He doesn't sniff, he dives in the hops.
The better the hops are, the more complexity, fullness, and richness you're going to get into each bottle of Samuel Adams.
Any car insurance company can promise you comparison rates, but just how accurate are they? Progressive Direct spends thousands of hours every week making sure the comparison rates you get are correct. Because when you start with better information, you can make a better decision. That's Progressive. Every day, Progressive does something that's, well, progressive. They have this ticker that shows their car insurance rates and their top competitors. Right now on Progressive.com, you can see actual rates that people are getting. Sometimes Progressive is the lowest, sometimes they're not. Hey, if they're this helpful when you're shopping for car insurance, imagine how they'll be once you're a customer.
We are set for half number two. Maryland with a one-point lead over number nine, Gonzaga, but the Terps really shutting down Gonzaga down the stretch. Gonzaga went 0 for their last eight, missed their last eight shots in the first half, Rick, but a lot of Maryland pressure had much to do with that.
Maryland did a terrific job of getting a hand up on a shooter, forcing him to drive off a closeout. Their goal was not to let him shoot with their feet set, and they've accomplished a lot of that, with the exception of getting burned on the press. Here we're going to look at Morrison and why he's so good. Transition, how about that body control up and under, left to right? Here he runs the floor, scoop shots, comes underneath the rim. There he falls, his shot in, and he came from half court to make that tip. Here he does a nice job of creating contact and gets to the free throw line. But Dottie, you can see they put Nick Kaner medley on him, they put McCray on him. They're trying to keep fresh blood on him. This is going to be a terrific second half here.
He had 13 points and 5 rebounds in the first half. We talked about the fact that Nick Kaner medley did not score in 15 minutes of play in the first half. And Maryland will open up with the basketball and leading by one in this battle of two top 20 opponents. Kaner medley answers. Boy, he must have heard it. In fact, when he checked in the ball, he's right in front of us. I think he got upset about that.
And they ran an offensive play, a flex cut against their zone to get him the ball. So you could tell it was a nice move by Gary Williams to show confidence in his star to get him the ball in that situation.
Average about 16 points a game as a junior, but a quick response as they get it inside. Morrison is an excellent passer as well. There have been a lot of comparisons to him and, say, a young Larry Bird. Do you think there's any fairness to that?
No, I don't think there's validity to that. Bird was a much better rebounder, but Bird was a great passer.
Bird right off the runway to stuff it back in. Fargo forcing the tempo, lost it. And now...
here's to a throwdown right there. Yeah. Timeout, coach. I'd take one quick, and he does. He's a veteran coach. He goes right to that 30-second timeout, as well he should.
Okene Ebekwe, the 6'9 junior, high up into the rafters twice.
Codebreakers, an ESPN original movie, Saturday, December 10th at 9 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
Yeah, great. Bye.
The world's first phone with iTunes. Only $149.99. Only from Singular. Raising the bar.
I've been thinking a lot about McDonald's double cheeseburgers lately. The perfect melding of two. Two juicy burgers, two slices of cheese, two halves of a bun. It's kind of like me and my girlfriend, you know? The two of us. Except the double cheeseburger only cost me $1 on the dollar menu. I guess that's where the similarities end. I'm cool with that.
Accidents happen. Nice to know the Jetta received the top overall crash rating in its class from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety.
ESPN
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's for all your home improvement needs. Lowe's, where improving home improvement never ends. And Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Maryland has opened up a 40-35 lead over Gonzaga. All part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. It's the EA Sports Maui Invitational. Back-to-back thunder dunks by Ekene Ibekwe, the 6'9 junior, who has been compared to Kevin Garnett as far as his style of play. And in the last couple of possessions, you see exactly why with that long reach of his.
He went upstairs for that last one. I'll tell you that. You got to put a body on him.
Morrison in traffic gets the jumper off, and it rolls out. And now Gonzaga is going a little bit cold. They certainly were down the stretch of the first half. Tanner Medley on the drive. Contact there, and he'll be shooting two. Let's go back to Ibekwe here as parents Agatha and Augustine hail from Nigeria.
Take a look at the timing on this. Good shot right there. Look how far out he comes from. And talk about a boarding house reach. I mean, that guy could get around me in the buffet line with an arm span.
And then the dunk, which rocked the house. Three fouls, by the way, on Pendergreff. Just picked up his third as he made contact on Kaner Medley. And a young man from Maine with a miss. Now to Portland, Maine. 6'8", 240. Maryland's top returning scorer. And the left-hander has also started more games than any current Terrapin. Mr. Basketball out of the state of Maine. He makes one of two.
Now they're letting Rabiot bring it up and letting Prego play off the ball more, which I think is a smart move.
Rabiot going with Strawberry head-to-head. Fargo off to Rabiot. Strawberry sticking right with him. He was in his shirt for the first 20 minutes.
Strawberry's a great competitor. Gary likes to yell at him because he can take it.
Rabiot stops and hits a three-pointer. They needed that one.
Yes, they did. Separation right there. You know what happens? Strawberry is a great on-the-ball defender and a great defender one pass away. He's got to learn to stay attached to his man coming off of those down screens, though.
McCray couldn't answer as he attempted a three. Fargo gets his shot. Morrison follows him and hits.
Transition. Maryland lacks communication there, and they don't stop the ball. It's an ebb and flow game.
Morrison has 15. Yes, with the swing. McCray looks like a guy who wants to start taking some shots and getting into the flow. Strawberry in the flow. It's in a three-pointer. 44-40, Maryland.
Here's where Strawberry's good. He's good on the ball. Now, here's where his concentration wanes, and he gets a little adventurous.
Batista, good back down there for the bank shot.
No way Gist should have let that happen. Gist is too good of an athlete and too strong. He's got enough of a body to not let Batista back him into the paint.
Well, the offensive pace is picking up in a major way here in the second half. The spin in by Ibekwe, and a foul there before the shot. Well, terrific action here. We've got more coming your way tonight in the EA Sports Maui Invitational. First at 9. It'll be Hassan Adams in number 8 Arizona against the Kansas Jayhawks at 11:30 on ESPN2. Arkansas and Josh Boone at number 3 UConn. The EA Sports Maui Invitational with its best field ever. Four fouls on David Pendergraft for Gonzaga, although they force a turnover, and Fargo has it for the Zags here. Rabiot hits that one. Well, really falling back right into his own bench.
Nice pass ahead there. And that was Maryland's nemesis. That turnover wasn't caused by Gonzaga. That was just lax play on the inbound pass. You've got to have precision in your offensive execution.
Morrison picks up the loose ball. Moments ago, though, Ed Hightower, the referee, motioning to Mark Few, you get back inside your coach's box. You've strayed too far. He's on him a bit. Batista, short range, and can't get it to go. And Gist cradles the rebound. He has four. Tanner Medley scored in the opening seconds of the second half. He hit the runner, but he did not get it. Morrison calling for the ball underneath. Gets it.
He is not a speed demon, but you know what he is? He is a hard worker. He got out wide, circled in, cut the angle on that break, He runs the floor every time. I love Morrison's heart.
And that might be where the comparisons to Bird are more apropos, his ability to see ahead of the action. Tanner Medley far away from the basket. The left-hander gives it up, and now the swing.
He's definitely an anticipator, Morrison.
Oh, nice sweet shot by number 15, Gist. James Gist.
Tough shot, too. They got a hand up on a shooter.
But he can get up there with anybody in America. All tied up at 46. We have a timeout.
What a game.
This is what we expected. Zaga 46, Maryland 46.
Thank you very much.
That fly suspect that I was done for.
Me?
The future looks so bright. In fact, it looks so bright.
I feel as if they're polishing
the sun for me.
Thank you very much.
120 not-so-standard features.
Thank you very, very, very much.
One all-new German-engineered Passat.
What gives a man ultimate shaving performance? Braun Activator's revolutionary foil with differently shaped holes captures hair growing in any direction for a closer shave in fewer strokes. And the world's most advanced automatic cleaning sensor leaves it feeling like a new shaver every day. Try the Braun Activator. It's the world's best self-cleaning shaver, guaranteed.
What do you do when he's hungry for Meat Lovers, she wants a Supreme, and you want your favorite? Well, Pizza Hut's got the answer. The amazing new More for All. An extra large pizza topped any four ways you want for just $13.99. Now, everybody gets more of what they really want. To fully satisfy your family, you need the extra large More for All pizza from Pizza Hut. Just $13.99. More for me, more for you, more for all. Gather around the good stuff.
I never thought I'd miss you half as much as I do.
Paradise in basketball, that's the EA Sports Maui Invitational. And this exceptional first-round matchup between Maryland and Gonzaga was not even supposed to be part of the Invitational this year. Originally, DePaul and not Gonzaga was scheduled to be here, but DePaul had to withdraw when they moved to the Big East. And because UConn was already invited to Maui, only one school from each conference could participate. Three-pointer right on the money.
Maryland
can give you a little of everything, Kenny.
That's been a, if there has been a little bit of a question, it's been his ability to hit the three.
No question there on Travis Garrison, a little fall away from the corner as he gets two.
I don't like that shot, but.
But it went.
But it went down. It's one of those where you're up as a coach and then, all right.
I'll take it now. Margo on the dribble drive, inside the foul line. The rebound off Strawberry's hands. He hasn't made many mistakes in this contest. But he could not get a handle on that one. It'll stay on this end. 49-48 Gonzaga. They will retain possession.
Strawberry's got to stay disciplined because this ball come back for Rabiot for a three here. If they can't catch something for Morrison, Rabiot's coming right back in here for a jump shot.
Morrison strips. It's Ibekwe giving the ball up. Right back to him for two.
You can put that ball up a foot above the rim and you bet Wayne won't get that baby.
Nick Cannon Medley with an outstanding feed. Ibekwe has six, and it's Maryland back in front.
Nothing energizes your defense like a dunk. Here we see Strawberry gambling unnecessarily. And it cost him right there.
He knocks his down.
Strawberry tries to make too many home run plays. You know, he gambles there, he overplays.
Well, home runs work in the family, don't they? Strawberry.
Yeah, that's a good line. You're right about that.
Gainer Medley up high. Zips another fine pass underneath. The lay-in won't go for Garrison. He's denied. Defended very well on that baseline. Gonzaga's gotten hot. Rick, they had a stretch where they were 4 for 20. Maryland took the lead. Now Gonzaga has hit 7 of their last 9 to lead by 1.
A lot of it has to do with shot selection.
Ballon. Downtown for 3.
Pick and pop. Good separation.
His first points of the game. Gonzaga opening up a 4-point lead. Gary Williams is going to get Mike Jones, his sharpshooter, into the game. Garrison with a turnaround. Got it. Nice touch there.
Into that zone. That was a good shot. Garrison's a big target. He's worked hard on that turnaround jump shot.
He has 6 points, and now Morrison will help run the offense. Coming up on 13 minutes left in this round one Maui matchup between Gonzaga and Maryland. Michigan State has already advanced, dusting off Chaminade earlier today. They take the winner of this one tomorrow. Shot clock at 7. Rivio gives it up to Pargo. Very quick. Someone has to shoot it. Heitfeld does, coming down the lane.
Great patience. Took Maryland to the end of the clock. Pargo made a big-time play there for a young kid.
56-52. Gainer Medley. Pretty quiet offensive day so far. Did not score in the first half at all. Beckway with a kick to McCray, and it catches the back iron. Mallon will take the rebound. Gonzaga to push it. Morrison looking ahead to Heitfeld, but he's traveling. He gives it up.
Gonzaga's the one creating tempo right now. That's Maryland's stock and trade. Gonzaga's the one getting out on the fast break, but here comes a Maryland strength. They're getting subs in, fresh blood at 3 positions. Here's Maryland's fast break right there. Good lead. Painter Medley makes a pass like a guard. You're 6'8", 235-pound three-man. Laying that up there like he's a one or a two.
That's a very unselfish team. They had 10 different men, Maryland did, get into the assist column in their season opener against Fairleigh Dickinson.
Rabiot trying to go back at Strawberry with a little ball pressure, giving him some of his own medicine.
Gary Williams sweating away over there, as is his wont, even though they put in a terrific air conditioning system here at the Lahaina Civic Center a couple of years ago. McCray, very sweet with that jump shot from close range.
That's his patented move. It's his go-to. He understands that shot about as well as anyone. He gets separation on him. He gets balance. What he really does is get his head up on the target. He's always long off the back of the rim on that.
Rivio directing traffic here. Heitfeld did not take Batista slashing through the lane. The guard trying to create something, fouled on his way to the basket with 11:34 left here in the second half, and it's tight. Gonzaga's lead 2 here in the Maui quarterfinals.
All design begins with a single line. A line that challenges. A line that creates power or control or size. At Infinity, a line has been drawn.
Scott?
Mm-hmm.
Did you possibly switch chairs with me?
No, not me.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Good luck finding your chair, LeBron.
Okay. Okay.
This is baby Tommy. Look at
those. Ooh, a slim, gorgeous beauty in my living room every night. What a picture.
With a chance to win one of 50 high-def, slim-fit TVs, it's hard to concentrate on anything besides the Samsung sweepstakes.
Wonder how high the volume goes.
To enter, go to DirectTV.com and register at Viewer Circle, exclusively for DirectTV customers. Viewer Circle, where you get great stuff just for being a customer.
Gonzaga up 56-54 over Maryland with 11:34 left in this one. Let's give you a look at Adam Morrison, the All-America candidate, moving without the basketball so well.
We're going to see Morrison here. He's starting to come off of a down screen, then he chooses the back cut. So here's Morrison to begin with. Now he back cuts, and he's open right there. Stop it. And he comes back for a post-up. Now, as we continue this play, they've had opportunities to hit him. Heifelt missed him on the back cut when he was open, and Morrison comes right over here to Heifelt, and he gives him a little bit of the what for, which is what an All-American is all about, and Heifelt takes it as constructive criticism.
A little bit of that All-America business, huh? Another timeout. This is a quick one. 56-54. Adam Morrison, certainly an All-America candidate. Mark Few has called him one of the purest scorers I've ever seen. The 2005 First Team Associated Press All-America team. You could win a few with this one.
Yes, you could. I'll tell you what. Great shooter in Reddick. Great leader in D. Brown. Craig Smith, a wonderful low block player. And how about the landlord, Sheldon Williams, who can block shots with either hand, rebound, and doesn't score a lot of points, but impacts every game with his defensive presence.
Gonzaga coach Mark Few loves his junior All-America candidate, but he says that has only made life tougher on Adam Morrison.
Yeah, when you talk about teammates.
You know, he's had a great career thus far at Gonzaga, and certainly with the first team All-American, preseason All-American, that he's a marked man this year, but yet he's got the makeup and the mentality, I think, to be able to handle that and live up to it. And hopefully, I'm hoping people will see a difference not only in his body from over the summer and the offseason, but also in his game, that he's, invented some different ways to score.
Well, Morrison with 22 points after his jumper, but Strawberry takes command on the other end, and he'll be going to the line here. DJ Strawberry, the 6'5 junior out of Corona, California, who has shown off some lightning quick skills at the stripe here with 11:12 left. Rick Majerus, Dave O'Brien with you. And more great hoops to come here for Maui, Arizona and Kansas, and Arkansas and UConn coming up later today.
How about two freshmen in such a critical juncture in the game right now? Dave Felton and Fragel.
Fargo pulls up his dribble. Jones coming out to guard him. They do get it underneath to Batista, and Bowers is leaning over his back, the seven-footer. Down in the low block, it's 58-56 Gonzaga.
Bowers has got to body him out of that spot. He can't let him just come down there unimpeded. He's got to give him a little bit of a chuck and ride him out. Once you get that catch with 2 feet in the paint, it schools out with Batista.
Batista, former standout at Barton County Community College in Kansas, where he averaged about 20 points a game, and he led Barton to the junior college national championship game before coming to Gonzaga. And he is at the line here, eager to shoot, but they're trying to straighten out the foul situation.
He plays with a nice stoicism. You know, he lets the game come to him, yet he's a dominant low block player.
Tanner Medley coming back in along with Ibekwe. Bowers did pick up his second personal there, Rick.
What's interesting, his hands aren't as large as you would think, given those shoulders and everything else about him. I mean, he's got big hands, but Morrison may even have bigger hands.
I used to say that about Artis Gilmore for a seven-footer, very small hands.
Yep. Him, another guy was Moses Malone at small hands.
60-56 Gonzaga. Strawberry across midcourt.
But like those guys, Batista has strong hands. Gonzaga man-to-man now.
A kick there, 10:43 left in the second half.
And this pace and tempo favor Gonzaga. Maryland's got to do something to get this more to 94 feet. You can't press, though, until you score.
Garrison tried to get it to the foul line, and Ibekwe, 15 seconds to shoot it. Jones almost lost it again, but they got the bucket. He found Ibekwe. Pretty big target there, the 6'9 junior. He has 8 points.
Now watch Mallon separate. They got him before in a pick and pop.
Batista on the catch, but he's doubled up in the paint and tied up as well. Now one official, Hightower, called for foul.
And Hightower is telling you who's in charge right now.
A foul before the basketball was tied up. He's a crew chief. Very authoritative on that call. I have to give it that. Let's see if he got it right.
Well, we'll take a look at it.
Batista on the catch.
Did
Garrison foul him?
I think he did.
Morrison lost it, but he's hammered in the paint. Both sides starting to get very physical.
Morrison tries to jump into you a lot and induce a foul, induce contact. And they've done a good job with principle of verticality referees, particularly so in the last couple of years.
But how about with that? How about the idea of jumping into a guy and creating contact?
Well, you know, that's a rookie referee will get baited into that. A good ref will understand that that's not part of the deal.
Morrison with 22. He's already beaten his average last year of 19 a game.
You can jump as he jumps into you, and you have the right to your verticality of space, which simply means you're perpendicular to the floor or the ceiling as you jump up. As long as you don't swat down, oh, that's unusual.
Yeah, two misses because Gonzaga, before that, was 14 out of 16 from the foul line. Garrett, very good free throw shooting team that Mark Few has. And his club is up 5-2, 10 minutes to go.
Well, we talked about this earlier. They're the more skilled team, and there's no greater skill than shooting. Maryland's the more athletic team. Gonzaga's changed defenses again. That's been a good ploy for them to alternate between the zone and the man.
A lot of time being taken off here. Shot clock at 7. Strawberry spins in, and he spit clean on the play. Gonzaga forcing the turnover. It's Morrison. No foul. And it's Strawberry up ahead of everybody.
That's because he didn't run back after he lost the ball. Now he's coming up with a little bit of a limp.
But this one is all tied up.
Strawberry's got to take discipline here on Raviol. Gary's got to look to get him out if he, in fact, is hurt.
Raviol back to Downing.
That's where you want to go right there.
Finds Batista, but Garrison's right with him. He got it up and in there anyway. That's a power move.
You want to stay deployed. He finds your body, finds your hip. You start to get on one side of his butt cheek, he spins off you. You've either got to be in front of him or you got to be behind him. Once you get angled, you got no chance against Batista because he's strong and he finishes in traffic and he's got a great touch.
You're right about Strawberry. He's come up a little bit gimpy here as he clutches at that right leg or the ankle. 8:51 left. Let's see how he hurt this. DJ Strawberry. This is when he lands after the dunk. As you said, he did not get back down, and yet he got the basket. But because he didn't get back down defensively, that might have been why he got hurt.
Yeah, now I see why he didn't get back down. I didn't see him land that way.
Jones with a long one. Not there for him. Allen collecting the weak side rebound. Gonzaga up 62-60. You did not like that shot.
No, I did not like that shot with the time and score consideration and just coming in off the bench. I mean, you're not warmed up. I like those guys off the bench to at least touch the ball a little bit before they jack it. Now they're fronting Batista. They got Gist on him.
Raviol off the screen. Got it.
Oh, what a tough shot.
Three-pointer.
Hand up on a shooter. McCray couldn't have played any better. Credit Raviol with the biggest shot of the night to date.
Raviol now with 15. 65-60. Gist on a turnaround. A little too strong.
A little too fast. A little too rushed. A little too much hand up.
Morrison, by the way, now with 9 rebounds to go along with 22 points. So he's had a day. Works his way in. Forced it. Picks it off. And the foul is going to go against Morrison.
He reached over him. That was a good call.
Timeout. Number 2 on the All-America candidate, Adam Morrison. His Gonzaga Bulldogs are up 5 over Maryland.
I tell everybody who comes to Hawaii to relax. Unwind and just cruise. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is nothing at all.
The people of Hawaii would like to share their islands with you. Plan your trip now at GoHawaii.com.
All design begins with a single line. A line that challenges. A line that creates power.
or control, or size. At Infinity, a line has been drawn.
What's he doing here?
Beats me. Can I help you, sir?
I'm looking for our security.
Yes, sir. Our security is in the network, sir.
This blinky thing is our security?
The security thing is everywhere the network is, sir.
Let me get this straight. The security is in the blinky thing, and it's in the doohickey next to the blinky thing? This is technical jargon, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Security powered by Cisco.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by the Maui Visitors Bureau and the magic of the Isles of Maui, Molokai, and Lanai. And Infinity, using the power of design to create dynamic, beautiful automobiles.
You know, it's not all about Vince Young down in the heart of Texas. Daniel Gibson going to lead the Horns in the Guardians Classic, the semifinals against West Virginia. That's coming up. Tip-off, 7:10 Eastern Time.
Guys, thank you very much. Great to see the former Gonzaga star, Roni Turioff, who had heart surgery in July, supporting his old club after being diagnosed with an enlarged heart. That was discovered only after the Lakers drafted Roni in the second round of the NBA draft in a team physical. Could well have been fatal had he continued to play with it. Mark Few and the entire Gonzaga coaching staff were with Turioff's family for that surgery. Pretty remarkable stuff. Of course, Roni made his name right here in Maui 3 years ago, Rick. Burst onto the scene in this tournament in a first-round win over your Utah team.
Yes, he did. We still got road burns on us. He came over our backs. He had those Ubekwe dunks that we saw earlier against us. We didn't put a body on him. He made us pay a price.
Morrison passing out of the double team, which he does so well. Gonzaga within the offensive zone. They have gone 13 of 18. The Zags have shooting the ball in the second half, 72% to take a five-point lead.
What they've done is they've tempoed this game. They've got it at the pace they want to play it at, not what Maryland wants to play it at. And they've gone inside to that man right there.
Batista in traffic, hooks it in.
He gets angled again. By getting an angle, I mean you have to deploy so your body's aligned right behind his, or you have to front him. When you get to a sidearm, he's too wide. In college, and especially with a narrow lane, even this experimental lane is a bit wider, you cannot afford to get angled and get caught on the side of somebody.
Gaynor Bentley, not there for him. Although he retrieves the loose ball, fires it again. Boy, he's just cold. He's had a miserable day shooting the ball. That's a major reason that Maryland is down 7 with less than 6.5 minutes left.
He's pressing. He's got his game speeded up. He's not locating the rim. He gets his eyes up late to his release. I feel bad for him. He has done a reasonably good job defensively, especially on those segments where he played Morrison. But
well, Adam Morrison just picked up his third foul. Kaner Medley has made only one shot, though, today. Strawberry returns to run the point. And number 20 Maryland down by 7 McCray. Oh, that would have been a big one. It rims out, however. And it's Gonzaga in command of the game at the moment. It's really theirs for the taking. Up by 7 points. Batista again. The back shot rolls off the rim.
Can't go inside him enough. Every time you go into him, something good happens. That was a good shot. They're getting great percentage shots. And Maryland's turning the ball over, taking bad ones.
Livio fouled from behind after he made the steal.
Good timeout here by Williams. He's trying to settle his troops down.
6 minutes left. Timeout, Maryland. And the Terps have fallen behind by 7 to the number 9 team in America. Gonzaga coming off a win over Idaho. Hey, coming up, Feast Week continues, presented by Lowe's. Number 13, West Virginia, battling number 2, Texas. That's on the way next on ESPN2. And Kentucky and Iowa coming up at 9 o'clock Eastern Time, 6 o'clock Pacific. Rick Majerus and Dave O'Brien with you. Well, it's a point in the game where Maryland has fallen behind, coach, by 7. What do they do to creep back into this thing?
They've got to quit being baited by those wild shots. Kaner Medley going one-on-one, taking, you know, fall-away shots. That jump shot right there, the three ball, And then they have an, and then what they've got to do though is control Baptista, because they're playing him. Morrison's not hurting him. Rabiot's not hurting him. Baptista's hurting him.
See Gary Williams working hard on his bench, a former Maryland point guard in his own right, in his 17th season at Maryland. He really likes this team, although he thinks they'll be a lot better a month from now than they are here this afternoon in Maui. Rabiot got the three, and they're hitting everything they take now.
He's very good.
Gonzaga with their biggest lead of the day. It's 10.
And what makes him very good is he can shoot the catch and shoot three, and he can shoot that separation three off the pick, and he's got NBA range when he shoots it.
Strawberry straight away with a drive into traffic. The kick out. Here's McCray. Not there for him.
All jump shots.
And a foul to go against Gonzaga as Travis Garrison went up for the rebound. I'm just amazed, though, that Nick Kanter-Medley, who's picked as one of the 50 preseason candidates for the John Wooden Award in the All-American team, has been so quiet today. Pettergraf has just committed his fifth foul, and he'll head to the bench.
You know, there's not an aspect of play that Kanter-Medley sort of hangs his hat on. He's not a low-block player. He's not an outstanding perimeter shooter. He's off to the side of the rim on misses too much for that. He definitely doesn't have a middle game. You know, he's one of those guys that, you know, you've got to generate some shots for him, and your offense has got to get him scoring opportunities, and Maryland hasn't done that.
He's been held to 3 points all day after averaging 16 last year as a junior, and he had 18 in the season opener against Fairleigh Dickinson. He has been silenced by the Gonzaga defense. And Gonzaga leads 70-60. The first double-digit lead of the day. As we check back with Star Watch, Morrison has been all that with 22-9. Kanter-Medley 1-for-6 shooting. Maryland with the basketball, and Kanter-Medley has it straight away. 5:20 to go, and Maryland starting to run out of time. The winner moves on to take on Michigan State. They dusted off Division II Chaminade earlier today at a game that started at 9:30 a.m. Maui time. Here's Kanter-Medley off the rim. Rebounded away. Comes to Gist. He stripped and fouled on the play.
He gets shooting out of rhythm. Out of rhythm shots are hard. By that I mean he pass faked and then he went back into the shooting motion. That's difficult to hit those kind of shots. That's a special player that hits those shots.
Sean Mallon picking up his third foul to send Gist to the line.
Number 15, James Gist.
Gist really the anti-John Gilchrist, the mercurial, moody presence on this Maryland team the last couple of years. Gist, a very upbeat, enthusiastic guy. Williams loves his energy. Ibekwe back in.
They feel that Gilchrist may have been, his leading may have been a case of addition by subtraction. Gilchrist dominated the ball without dominating the game.
The lead at 8. Morrison brings it across. Nearly turned it over, though, as he had McCray right in his shirt. Fargo's been impressive today in his major college debut.
Yes, he has. And what I liked about him most is his attitude. Here, he pushes him from behind. They got him in a bad way, and Gist arm bridges him and pushes him way off the block. Makes it so obvious.
Gist with a foul. That's his second. Just 4:41 left for Williams and the Terps. Gary Williams has had a fascinating 5 years, hasn't he? One of the college game's most driven personalities. He's twice taken Maryland to the Final Four, won the national title once. Then his last three teams have won 10, 12, and 13 games. Lost 10, 12, and 13 as Morrison gets inside and now has 24 points.
Morrison is a clinic on cutting, moving without the ball, changing pace. The minute he saw his man turn his head on him, he back cut to the rim. Rabiot laid that bounce pass off. Morrison is a special, special offensive player.
We'll see if the Terps have a run in him here. Down by 10. Kanter-Medley trying to start that. Gives it off to Strawberry, and he knocks down a three-pointer. DJ Strawberry with a triple. He has 16.
This is their biggest defensive possession. They've got to stop here to win the game.
That's been a real problem for Maryland, a criticism. Their inability to shoot the three-pointer very well. Made some coaching decisions. filling a couple of vacancies, including Michael Adams, who's on the bench now. He's a great three-point shooter in his day. They are 5 out of 12 on threes today. Laviolette lost it. Strawberry,
and they got the ball. Great presence of mind to call the timeout.
Call the timeout while hitting the deck. Timeout, Maryland, and they'll have the basketball.
And we said they had to have a stop here to set them up for a win. That was a great play right there.
They've been talking about a couple of the coaching changes that have been made by Gary Williams. A couple of knocks on Maryland. They haven't recruited the blue chip kids as much as schools like Duke, Kentucky, and others. His decision to bring on Michael Adams, of course, played for him at Boston College, went on, had a great career in the NBA, and also Charlotte assistant Rob Moxley.
We've got Strawberry, though, over here cramped up, and I want to refer back to what you, but I'll tell you what, I don't think they win it without Strawberry, because he brings a defensive presence to it and can make a pass. He can make a play for himself to get to a big pass, so McCray has a chance to hit a three. It looks like he got back up, though. Maybe it was worse than I thought.
72-65. Did you have a big issue with dehydration and cramping your kids when you were taking Utah here?
No, we never had that issue. But I had our trainers and doctors told them to drink and water and, you know, that type of thing. I haven't seen this as so much of an issue.
Well, Michigan State, their loss to Hawaii over in Oahu the other day, they had all sorts of terrible cramping issues and dehydration. Played a major role in their loss and that upset to Hawaii.
Where do you go for your basket here? Gary wanted to know who is going to be a star. He's going to have a chance to find out.
Strawberry gets it inside to McCray. He's hammered in the act of shooting. He'll go to the line with 3:10 left. We'll see if Morrison got hit with another one.
Not a bad spot to go to. That's who I would have gone to as well. Good call by Gary.
Morrison has just picked up his fourth foul. Could be huge here down the stretch in the Maui quarterfinals.
Tony, most people want to get in better shape, but they just don't have the time.
Well, Stacy, what if I told you in just 3 20-minute workouts, only 1 hour a week, you can increase your energy levels, strengthen your heart, reduce your stress, and shape all the muscles of your body, all with one quality machine. Would you be interested?
Yes, I would.
Well, Stacy, I have good news.
Tell me more.
I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico. Yeah, baby, you can do it.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The fresh toasted chicken and bacon ranch sandwich from Subway Restaurants is made with tender chicken, shredded cheese, real bacon, tasty ranch dressing, and freshly baked bread. We'd say it's a sandwich eater's finest hour, but that's 59 minutes longer than it takes to devour it. Subway, eat fresh.
All design begins with a single line. A line that challenges. A line that creates power or control or size. At Infinity, a line has been drawn.
Every Subway sandwich is made fresh right in front of you, so you choose all the ingredients. The meat, the veggies, the fresh baked bread. No wonder so many people are coming over to the great taste of Subway subs. Because when you really think about it, they don't make the sandwiches. You do. Subway. Eat fresh.
Now the big game really is in your room.
That's unbelievable!
ESPN and Fisher-Price introduced the ESPN Shot Block Basketball. It's the only basketball game with built-in defense, featuring the voice of ESPN's own Dick Vitale.
Wow, what a nice shot!
With electronic scoring and real crowd noise, the ESPN Shot Block Basketball gives you 8 different ways to play, from rookie to pro.
What a performance like that, you might be on SportsCenter!
Take it to the hole with the ESPN Shot Block Basketball. In stores now, batteries not included.
Tipping off 10 minutes after the hour, a man whose name has been turned into a verb. Will Texas get pet snoggled by West Virginia? Guardians Classic semis coming up in a bit.
Gonzaga up by 7. They've shot 73% here in the second half. But moments ago, Adam Morrison just picked up his fourth foul, the Gonzaga star. The question is, Rick, how will Gonzaga do against the inevitable Maryland press?
Maryland's going to press. They're going to probably go with a ball pressure, 1-2-1, one press, trying to generate a turnover. If I'm Gonzaga, I take nothing but a layup, because if I pull the ball back out and I go late into the shot clock, their offensive execution is so good, and they got 3 viable scoring options with Baptista, Morrison, and Raviole.
McCray, an excellent foul shooter. In fact, 90% last season, which was sixth in the United States, second in the ACC, only to J.J. Redick. As another one coming here.
The two timeouts left are going to be critical. I wouldn't be afraid to take one if I run into a problem here.